This is Dr. Lam, founder of drlam.com, and today we're going to talk about how exercise relates to adrenal fatigue. Now, a large part of our exercise regimen, people think of a cardiovascular system. In order for exercise to happen aerobically, the sympathetic nervous system, or what we call the sympathetic response, has to be triggered. This involves the hormones norepinephrine as well as epinephrine. Now, very important, is to understand that first, before you can even exercise, your autonomic nervous system has to be in control. The blood pressure and the heart rate cannot be too high and cannot be too low. It has to be commensurating with the degree of exercise that you do. People that have the ability to control this will have no problem exercising. However, if you have a sympathetic response that is actually too high or too low, then you will have a problem. In fact, one of these problems is called postural orthostatic tachycardia, and that affects people that even when they stand up, it's called POTS, P-O-T-S. And when you stand up, your autonomic nervous system and your sympathetic response get into play. However, they are unable to regulate, so therefore there's an over-response of adrenaline that comes out from the body, leading to a heart rate that is really fast from 100 to 120 at the moment you stand up. Now, this type of fast heart rate usually only happens when you're in exercise mode, but these people have this problem just to stand up. Understanding this sympathetic response is critical because what you want to do is that you want to have it activated, but you have to have it under control. So it's like going into a bathroom and taking a shower. You want a warm water, but you don't necessarily want to have hot water, and you don't want to have only cold water. So this modulation usually happens automatically by the body. But when the body is under adrenal fatigue, and this mechanism may be affected. And when it is affected and become dysregulated, then you can have an over-secretion or under-secretion. Both are no good, because when you have over-secretion, your heart is going to start pounding very quickly, even before you exercise. And while you may even feel good during the exercise, you can actually have a post-exercise crash. If, on the other hand, you have under-secretion, the sympathetic response is undertone, then you're not going to be able to even have the energy to get up to the heart rate that is required for aerobic capacity, and you will feel drained just even with walking. So having the right balance really reflects a underlying, well-tuned autonomic nervous system. The sympathetic response is the key in this component. And along with the parasympathetic nervous system, they balance each other. People who are healthy have no problem. People with adrenal fatigue often can find an imbalance. And the key is to allow the body to rebalance it itself. Because once it rebalances, then you're going to be able to exercise at the right degree, at the right time, and feel good and don't have any post-exercise crashes. Well, how do you do it? And the way to do it is to start to rebuild the body slowly but steadily with various forms of exercise that build the core but not overly exaggerate the sympathetic response. So you have to go through this process slowly. You can start with adrenal circulation exercise and then with adrenal restorative exercise, then go into a series of adrenal yoga exercises, and finally to aerobic in a progression. This may take some time, but it's the right way to do it properly and allow the body to rebuild on its own. If you try to do it otherwise with the use of medications or stimulants in order to get your body into the exercise mode, oftentimes it can backfire and lead to adrenal crashes and relapses. And so those are less desirable. So in summary, exercise is important, but the more important is the right kind of exercise and the right intensity and the right frequency when you have adrenal fatigue. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I've written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, If you enjoy this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.